Hi, and welcome to this online support session for question number one on unit one, activity two, the assignment that's due tomorrow. There have been a lot of questions about writing vectors in terms of two or three other vectors, and here is the question one. Now, the diagram is similar to what you see in the question. The one I've chosen is just one I've made up that's off of the assignment, are very similar to the assignment. So the best way to handle a question when you're asked to express a vector, let's say in this case EC, which is this area here, in terms of AB and EF, is done this way. First step is just to take your vector that you're being asked to explain and write it in something that is very easy to see and something that you know quite easily. And in this case, it's ED, that'd be a good first step, plus DC. Okay, now I want you to notice that that vector EC, okay, is expressed in a relationship where it's ED, okay, so it starts at E, it goes to an intermediate point D, and then the second vector picks up at D and ends at C, and that's your end point from the original vector EC. Now, if we proceed with the next line, okay, hopefully you'll see pretty quickly that ED is the same as AF. Okay. ED is exactly the same vector as AF. Order is important in this case. E starts at E, goes to D, starts at A, and goes to F. Similarly, DC is the same as vector, my mistake, BD. That's a D there, folks. Okay, so that second line of the solution can be replaced with AF plus BD, both being vectors. Third line. Vector AF can be replaced with vector 1 half AB. Similarly, vector BD can be replaced with vector FE. Got it so far? Okay, let's just take a look at this diagram. So EC is now in terms of 1 half AB plus FE. We're close. We're very close to what we've been asked to do. I can leave this alone because it is in terms of A, B, as I was asked. But I need to change vector FE, just a little bit of a change here to satisfy the original question. So basically I'm changing vector FE into vector EF somehow. Okay, I think you've maybe picked up the fact that putting a negative sign in front of a vector just basically changes the direction. So we change the vector the point system here. So basically we've got 1 half AB plus, in brackets, negative E half. Simplifying. Gives us required solution. Okay, now finally I would just to finish it off and make it more mathematical, bring that down. And that's what you have, folks. And certainly this one, if you followed this solution, this one's probably a lot harder than any one of the question one A, B, or C that you'd get on the assignment. So again, if you followed this, I think you should be good, certainly good enough to handle question number one. Yeah, well, thanks, and keep in touch again.